So here we are today. I'm actually going to do a face product review on three different new products that I've recently purchased. And I'm just going to go ahead and talk about them. But quick note is I have no makeup on my skin and I feel like my skin looks so good. The only thing I have on right now is my eye area and some lip gloss. But I feel like my skin looks so good. I've been using that Olay CC cream, so I feel like it is repairing my skin. I feel like it feels supple. I've just been using it every single day in the morning under my makeup and then my usual nighttime skin routine, and I love it. Like, I feel like it feels so good. So today I'm going to talk about, as I said, three face products. So let me just pull my hair back here. Okay, so hair is back, and I want to talk about three different products. So the first one I want to talk about is the Maybelline. This is the Age Rewind makeup, and I love the concealer, so I decided let me go and give the makeup a try. So I really like that so far. I've also tried the new Maybelline 24 hour super stay makeup, so I have that, and also CoverGirl BB cream. All right, so the first thing I want to talk about is the CoverGirl BB cream. Now, I did get the color light to medium. I felt that this product, it is tinted moisturizer. It says right on there, tinted moisturizer. Let's see. Natural looking radiance, sheer color, all day hydration, improves skin elasticity, SPF blends effortlessly, lightweight, helps skin feel smooth, covers to help instantly improve skin's appearance and won't clog pores. So basically to me, this is like, I see beach, sweaty, hot daytime. So I did throw this on this morning just to do a little bit of shopping, and I liked it. It is very, very, very sheer. It didn't really cover up any kind of redness to me. It just kind of was like a tinted moisturizer, just as specified. So I liked it, but I didn't know if I liked it for just running around. I think this would be perfect for the beach. I mean, it really even says, you know, reapply every 2 hours, use water resistant sunscreen if swimming or sweating. So this would be great for a beach day, a out in the sun, really hot day where you don't want to have anything on your face and you just want it to look a little more even and glowy. So I don't want to put this on my skin today. I'm going to put the other two foundations on, but I'm just going to swatch it for you. So here is my skin. I picked the color light to medium. So at first you see it looks very light, but it does blend in, and it's just very thin and very moisturizing. There's not really a lot of color at all. Super, super sheer. I do like it. I just feel it's more moisturizer than cover, which is good. Not a bad thing. The other two products I'm going to show you today, I usually use it with my Olay, but I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to apply, this is some of the Hard Candy Face Primer, and I really like this, and this is like $6 at Walmart, so I really just like this. I'm just going to apply this to my cheeks. In the areas that I feel I need priming. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply half of one product on one side and half on the other side and just tell you how I feel about them, because I don't want to use like a really good brush. I'm just going to use my stippling brush here by Real Techniques to apply it. Now the, because you know, it's really hard to judge what color you need. So I feel like the Maybelline Age Rewind matches perfectly, and I got that in color 260 Buff. And I feel like the, Super Stay is a little bit too dark, but it works. Like, once I blend it down into my neck area, it works. When and my hair's down, it looks perfect. So this is in the Natural Tan. So let's start with the Maybelline Age Rewind, and this is just like all of the other Maybelline Age Rewind products. You just squeeze it till it comes out the top, and then you apply it. So I just like to dot it all over, and then I'm going to go ahead with the stippling and blend that in. And I didn't put any concealer on because I just want to show you how it cover, like how well it covers. Let's start by stating the obvious. The first thing that you see is that it does blend very well with my neck and the rest of my body. You can also tell that it's just a little bit darker than my natural skin tone, which is fine because it really evens me out because my face is always lighter than the rest of me. So it's just really smooth. And I remember I just put just a little bit of primer in my cheek area. It's super smooth. It was super easy to blend. And it's just a really nice product. And you can really see the color difference there in my forehead. Okay, so this side here is the Maybelline Age Rewind, and I really like it, not even because of the Age Rewind aspects. I just love the way that my skin feels so flawless. It's got a very satin finish. It's not too shiny. It's not too matte. It's just perfect. I don't really have to put a powder over top to set it. It's kind of pretty perfect for my skin and my liking. So I really do love this product. Also, you could see the under eye without even putting any concealer on. It covered and it evened up my under eye area. So you see that. And then once I put just a little bit of the concealer underneath, it's just perfect. So this is even good for a light makeup day. This does also have SPF 18 in it. Super concentrated goji berry and collagen, so I just feel like it feels really good on my skin. Okay, so the other one we're going to do is the Maybelline Superstay makeup. I mentioned this is a little bit darker, so you're going to notice a color difference to begin with. And I just go ahead, it's a little harder to apply because just blot it on. And you could apply it with a beauty blender or a brush, and I have found actually that the beauty blender is probably the best method for me in using this foundation. But I'll just go ahead and blot it on, and then I'm just going to use my stippling brush and blend it. Okay, so now I have that blended in, and it was relatively easy. You can just see, once again, the color difference, because I said this shade was a little darker. But if I really just blended this down in my neck area, it's not too bad. It's not too bad, considering the rest of my body there, so that's okay. The coverage is good. I feel like this is a little more dewy that I have to set this side, this makeup. And then, you know, you could see on my forehead there. Okay, so I'm going to include a picture of me before with the no makeup on, and now you can see me now. I think these are both really good formulas. I really do like Maybelline products. Coverage-wise, I feel like they are comparable. This Superstay is supposedly 24-hour wear, no transfer. I've never kept my makeup on for 24 hours, so I'm not sure. But I did use this makeup all day for work and then even went out. So it wasn't 24 hours, but let's say 20 hours. And I felt like it stood up. I feel like I do need to use a little bit of powder over top of this to set it. Just because I feel my skin does get a little extra dewy with this. No transfer now. I don't really rub on people to see if there's any transfer. So we're just going to pretend that this is a shirt and I am giving someone a hug. Very light. Definitely don't see any transfer. Unless you're a hugger that like rubs your face, oh hi, and rubs your face on there. I don't really see how makeup, I mean, I guess makeup does transfer, but we'll do that to the other side. I don't see any transfer on that side either. So they both pretty much set once they're on your skin. And what I do like about it is, especially if I do have to drag it down to my neck area, that I don't feel like you can see it and you can tell the difference that I have it on there. Adding a little bit of powder to this, and they both feel really good. As you can see in the screen, this one I feel has a little bit more coverage than this side. just because I still feel looking, let me look in the mirror too, because the screen, just because I can feel like you see a little less rosy on this side than you do here, but, you know, that may save you a step from your blush, so that may be good for you, but I really do like, this one does not have, it says it withstands heat, sweat, and humidity, no transfer, flexible, breathable, all-day comfort, oil-free, suitable for all skin types. This one does not have SPF in it, so this was, for me, this would definitely be inside at work or nighttime. If I'm going to be doing anything during the day where I will be outside for an extended period of time, I would rather choose a foundation that has SPF, but not forgetting that the primer that I'm using is the Olay, so that does have SPF as well. Sometimes SPF does have a bad flash on cameras. You do see a white, so some people do not like that. But all in all, I do think that both of these products are really good. I just use them for two opposite ends of the spectrum. So let's just quickly go through the bullet points real quick and end this video. So for me, the Maybelline Age Rewind, it has the SPF. Full coverage, sets easily with a satin finish. And then the Super Stay, long lasting, it's oil free, no transfer, and the colors are really comparable to skin tones. I really like them. So, that is it. I hope you enjoyed this review. Questions or comments, as always, leave them down below. And I will see you guys in our next video. Thanks for watching. Bye!